Former National Chairman of the ruling All Progressive Congress APC, Comrade Adams Oshiomhole, has again dismissed speculations that he is nursing an ambition to return to the office, saying he has decided to sleep on his rights. Oshiomhole spoke on Saturday when he chaired a fundraising ceremony and investiture of Mrs. Victoria Onaromi as 10th president of the Rotary Club of Abuja, Maitama. The event was also the 10th anniversary of the club. He also challenged Rotarians in the country to go out and get more politicians to join them and subscribe to the club's four-way test. Oshiomhole said, "The judgment quashing my removal was not actually delivered last week. It was on July 2nd, 2020. About 2 weeks after I was removed from office, the only reason I decided to publish it was because I saw comments suggesting that people were not aware that the case was dismissed. I had addressed newsmen shortly after my removal and said that regardless of the legality or illegality of my removal, I accepted what happened in good faith and resolved I will not contest it. I promise to remain committed, do what I can as a party member to support the party. You know, in law, you can decide, as I have done, to sleep on my rights. And as I took that decision to sleep on my rights, it has remained sleeping. I've decided for the purpose of the party chairmanship to sleep on my rights, and it remains happily so. You can see that I've been active since I left office because I don't think I need to be a chairman to remain relevant. I didn't join the party to become chairman, but because we wanted to form an alternate platform capable of taking PDP out of power, and that objective was achieved. It does not matter how it all went. But the important thing is that the primary purpose was not for me to be chairman." While he said he does not regret anything he has done, Oshiomhole also expressed optimism about the chances of Nigeria's democracy surviving after the 2023 elections. "I have hopes, not fears, for 2023. People like to talk about their fears, but for me, my life is about hopes. I think that by 2023, God will not forsake a nation of over 200 million people. Our democracy has come to stay. It is not perfect. A couple of things could be done to strengthen it, but we could move on and get on with the job. I strongly believe that God, in His infinite power, will help Nigeria to sustain democracy as we move through 2023. As an optimist, I always say that with all the problems that Nigeria have, soft Nigeria is still much more than the sum total of all the problems. Life is not all about regrets. I'm a very happy man. Or do you see me looking sad? I might look small, but not sad." Oshiomhole also spoke on the four-way test of Rotary, urging the club to get more politicians into its fold. He said, for reflections now, if I'm asked to compare the Rotarians, your principles and objectives to the objectives of the trade unions and labor movement, I will say that they have a lot in common. As president of the NLC, we were concerned with, is it the truth? That is why we never like to go to court, because the court is not about the truth. It is about the law, and the law is about the values of those in parliament, not necessarily the values of the larger society. So it needs not to coincide with what is fair and just, but that is the law, and society will be administered or disadministered according to those laws. So rule of law is not necessarily whether it is fair or just. Is it fair to all concerned? When I was at the trade unions, that question was at the heart of our struggle. Should people work so hard and end up being paid so little? Or as it is currently in many states, people work so hard and in the end, they are not even paid for months. Every other price is going up, only the poor price is going down. Governors past and present can afford current prices of cement, current prices for official vehicles, but they cannot afford current prices of minimum wage. And when it comes to wages, it is about having the ability to pay. I should pay according to my resources. But when you are buying a vehicle, you pay according to the market value of the vehicle. As a labor man, I was familiar with the first two questions, the truth and what is fair. But when the Rotarians say, is that the truth? The politician is likely to say, how does that affect me? Is it beneficial to all? The politician is likely to say, whose turn is it? So I think you should go out and get more politicians to join the Rotary Club and instill these core four-way tests as part of the core values that should guide us in office. I'm impressed by the fact that the Rotary Club is generally committed to supporting all kinds of causes, particularly those who need support. Every day you hear that someone was taken to IDP camp. He has huge challenges. The government will not be able to solve those problems if the people imbibe the values of Rotary, of giving, mobilizing, fun. I wish that more and more Nigerians recognize that a society whose value is about everybody to himself and his for us all cannot go too far. We must be able to contribute our own quota because the way the world is, even before COVID-19, everybody appeared to be daily economically victimized, and they will need good and kind-hearted people to support them. Oshomole, the former national chairman of the ruling All Progressive Congress, the suspended national chairman, he's just spoken. And you know, anytime Oshomole gets an opportunity to speak, he always speaks about what happened. You know, what he was attending was the 10th anniversary of the Rotary Club, but he just used that as a medium to, because he knows that this will go out to air his mind a little bit. And he's just spoken about speculations of him returning as the national chairman, that he has no thought of such, and that those who are cooking up that, or those who are insinuating about that, that he doesn't have any of such ambition to return back to office. If you followed closely, there was something he mentioned about talking about our courts are not necessarily about truth. That is so. In other means, what he's talking about is that what happened to him. You know, it was the Supreme Court that upheld the suspension. Invariably, he's stating that they did not do the right thing. But we know here he stated that he just decided to sleep on it. That he have chosen to sleep on my rights. He doesn't want to contest it. He doesn't want to go to court. But what he's saying with his what he's suggesting right now is that the courts are not they are not actually true. That the decisions that comes out of the court is as a result of those in charge, those in parliament, those who have power. They are the ones that controls the court. Quite interesting. Well, guys, let's hear your own take down below in the comment section. Thank you once again for staying tuned. And please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, click on the like button. If it's your first time, you're very welcome. Please hit on the subscribe button. God bless you. Till I come your way again with more updates. Bye.